गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्राइमरी बिलियरी कॉलेंजाइटिस, सो ऑल्सो नोन एज प्राइमरी बिलियरी सिरोसिस अंटिल 2015। इटियोलॉजी नॉट फुली अंडरस्टूड, ऑल्सो इट थॉट टू बी ऑटोइम्यून कंडीशन। वी कैन से इडियोपैथिक और ऑटोइम्यून, सेम लाइक primary sclerosing cholangitis, there also etiology unknown. Mechanism here is chronic inflammatory process, damage to intralobular bile duct, cholestasis and cirrhosis. Female is to male ratio is 9:1. Classical presentation, itching at middle age woman, okay. Now the association 80% with Sjögren's syndrome, primary biliary cholangitis and rheumatoid arthritis, systemic sclerosis and thyroid disease, whereas in primary sclerosing cholangitis association with ulcerative colitis or with HIV, but here is Sjögren, rheumatoid, systemic and thyroid disease. Okay, clinical features include asymptomatic like primary sclerosing cholangitis, same here, but raised ALP, alkaline phosphate in primary sclerosing, also same, and fatigue pruritus. Cholestatic jaundice we see, there also cholestatic jaundice, hyperpigmentation especially over pressure points, xanthomas, xanthoma, and clubbing and hepatosplenomegaly, fat malabsorption, vitamin A, D, E, K, back pain due to osteomalacia resulting from malabsorption or osteoporosis, hepatic osteodystrophy, late may progress to liver failure. Okay, diagnosis here by anti-mitochondrial antibodies, but in primary sclerosing cholangitis, diagnosis is by which antibodies? PNC antibodies and anti-nuclear antibodies, but here is with anti-mitochondrial antibodies, that is 98% of patient, highly specific, targeted against pyruvate dehydrogenase. Pyruvate dehydrogenase is found in mitochondria, required for the generation of acetyl coenzyme from pyruvate from entry into tricarboxylic acid cycle. Even smooth muscle antibodies, 30% of patient, raised IgM. Okay, in autoimmune hepatitis we see smooth muscle antibodies also. Liver function test correlates poorly with histology in primary biliary cholangitis. The disease may progress insidiously with normal or near normal LFTs. Okay. Management, in case of pruritus, we have to give cholestyramine, fat soluble vitamin supplementation. Also, ursodeoxycholic acid delays the need for liver transplant. Same in primary sclerosing cholangitis role. Also the ursodeoxycholic acid effectiveness in improvement in ALP, GGT, but ALP is more widely used than GGT. Okay, liver transplantation has a good prognosis, 90-95% survival, reoccurrence in graft can occur, but it is not usually a problem. So guys, I hope till here it's very much clear for you. If you have any queries, any question, you can ask me, and if you're new on my channel, please subscribe it. Thank you, good day, goodbye. That's all for today.